This morning in the kitchen, if you haven't heard already, Providence restaurant weeks have started. So Go Providence has brought us Cassarino. Chef Steven is here. We're making a menu that you can actually buy and purchase as part of restaurant week,
right? That's right. It will be on the restaurant week menu.
So tell everyone at home what we're making and what we need.
We are making a Gorgonzola encrusted sirloin this morning with a side of broccoli rabe. So some simple ingredients right off the bat. We have a choice grade New York sirloin steak, broccoli rabe, and to make the crust, we got some panko breadcrumbs, some unsalted butter, Gorgonzola cheese, and we have salt, pepper, garlic, red pepper flakes, and some fresh garlic, and just a little bit of oil. Simple ingredients, few steps.
Yeah.
So
I like that. Maybe, but the cheese, I'm sure, is really gonna create a nice flavor. So I like that you're kind of keeping everything else pretty simple. You said this was what, choice grade?
It's a choice grade.
What makes it that?
It would be the fat, the marbling within the steak.
Mm-hmm.
So when you see the white here, the fat through it. The next level up is prime, and the prime is the best you can get. So we're just one step under, but really nice. Should be a nice, tender, moist steak.
Great. And the fact that you're one step under, too, makes it a little more affordable,
I'm sure, for a lot of your customers coming in. It keeps it much more reasonable, but yeah, it's still a great quality steak.
Now, when they come in, I mean, it's served like this. How does it work, restaurant week? I know we're going to get more details later on, but they'll come in, and how much would a meal like this cost them?
This is part of the dinner menu, so it's $34.95.
Uh-huh.
We do give you a three-course menu.
Wow.
So we have an appetizer. This will be one of the entrees, and you get a dessert as well.
Great.
So it's quite a meal.
You're going to leave full, and maybe you'll even go home with a doggy bag at that point. We're going to show you how to make it and tell you more about restaurant weeks when we come back.
Continue to look at these fabulous prizes as we send it back to Michaela in the kitchen.
All right, thanks, Brendan. Chef Steven from Cassarino's, he's still here. Steven, what do you got going on? You going to work on the crust?
The first thing we would do is prepare the crust. So we take our panko breadcrumbs, just about a cup, and some butter that I let soften.
Nice.
So it's the equivalent of a stick of butter, and that goes in.
Okay.
And then we did a cup of crumbs, so I do a cup of the Gorgonzola.
Beautiful.
And we
just hand mix it.
Yeah.
All right, while you do that, Kristen Adamo is also here, too. We've been mentioning that Providence Restaurant Weeks, they officially started yesterday.
Yes.
And they're going to run for how long?
They'll run through the Saturday the 24th, so you get 2 weeks to try all of the restaurants you've been dying to try.
Which a lot of people, this is a great way to do that and experience it because it is so affordable.
It's very affordable. We have a three-course prefix lunch for $14.95, and then we have two levels of dinners for $29.95 and $34.95. Again, three courses, so you can really make a night of it and maybe use those restaurant gift cards you got for Christmas.
Yeah, that's a good point, too. It's nice to know that they can also be used during this time as well. How many restaurants are taking part?
The winter one, we have about 80, and there's a lot from all over the state. We've got a great concentration in Federal Hill, so it's a great time to go up there.
Mm-hmm.
But there's also, they're in Bristol, they're in Northern Rhode Island, we have a nice chunk in East Greenwich. So it's Providence Restaurant Weeks, and certainly most of them are from Providence.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're in the burbs and maybe don't want to come into the city for a minute, you've got some time.
That's nice. Or just see a different part of the state that you haven't been to
Absolutely.
Yet.
Absolutely.
Where should we go to find out which restaurants are taking part?
Well, we have a website, Providence Restaurant Weeks with an S.com, and they actually not only have a list of the restaurants, but they also have the menus. So what a lot of people like to do is almost plan out their entire 2 weeks based on what they feel like eating. So it's a really fun way to kind of even just kill some time looking at some good dishes.
Yeah, it's a good guide for you there. This dish is also on the menu over at Cassarino's, and we're going to finish things up later on in the show.
Go Providence to bring in the chef, Steve Renzi from Cassarino's, which is a Rhode Island staple. We've got Gorgonzola crusted sirloin and broccoli rabe on the menu. You can hear that that sirloin sizzling away and the smell. We're in the other room, and it smells great.
Excellent.
Smells great. What do we want to do right now?
So basically what I had done to get it started was I started pan-searing the sirloin off ahead of time because this will be the longest part of this meal. You can absolutely grill it as well. My recommendation is we finish it in the oven, so if you like a medium steak, prepare it medium rare because we're going to cook it another temperature up.
Right.
Oh,
so
okay.
We made our crust ahead of time. The steak is going. Next up is our green, which is our rabe. So we have it in a pan, and I just started it with some vegetable oil, and we just cook it till it wilts.
This is another one of those things, and if you live in Rhode Island, you have this with a lot of things. It's broccoli rabe.
Absolutely, absolutely. Especially on our menu at the restaurant,
we use it in
a few different ways.
Sure.
Simply seasoned, a little cracked pepper, a little bit of kosher salt, and we do add some red pepper flakes and a little garlic powder.
And again,
we're just cooking it to just to start wilting the leaves.
Right, just like you would spinach. Kind of treat it
absolutely.
Way.
And what we look for doneness on Robbie is the stems. We look to till the scent. When the stems are soft, they're ready.
They can be
a bit stringy.
Okay. That's a good tell.
So again, this is a very simple meal. Mm-hmm. So we've taken it, we've seared it off. I did season it, same type of spices, kosher salt, cracked pepper, and a little bit of garlic powder.
Beautiful. Now, as that's going and getting a nice sear, we want to remind folks at home, this is one of the items on your Restaurant Week menu, so you can come in and get this.
Yes, absolutely. And what we did different this year with Restaurant Week, we are offering our entire menu.
Wow. Really? Oh, that's nice.
Normally, we would do 4 or 5 entrees.
Right. Which is what most
Do, but we decided that we're going to offer the entire menu to give some variety, and hopefully everyone
can find
something to try.
All the more reason to check you out.
So we took the sirloin, we seared it off.
Like I said, you didn't go too long.
We're going to finish it in the oven. Mm-hmm. So our crust is here that we've softened butter, some gorgonzola cheese, and the panko crumbs, and we pretty liberally just really pack it down on there.
Smush it on there. I love the panko.
The panko we find works the best because when you do cut it, it is going to give you some crunch.
Yeah. A little crust to it. Correct?
A little more of a crust. Right. Right. You can use regular breadcrumbs, but we just find that this will give it a nice golden brown.
Between that and the pan sear that you've done before, it's nice to have that, but then nice, really tender in the middle.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And obviously, a lot of people know Cassarino's. It's a Rhode Island staple here. What are some of your other favorite things that you get to cook each day?
Just trying to get stuff that's local.
Right.
You know, a lot of seafood we bring in is from local. During the seasons, we're at the farms trying to bring in some new products.
Right.
But, you know, we try and cover all the bases.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That's good. That's
you
good.
Do. Now, that's a thick cut of steak there. Time and temp on the oven when we bake it.
This, again, I pan seared it. It's been going in the pan for 10 minutes, probably another 10 minutes in the oven to get to a nice medium rare.
Beautiful.
So what I did in the meantime was I did have one already prepared.
Okay.
So this will come in.
Look at this.
And this one will come out.
This looks fantastic.
And I do have some rabe.
Right
that
there.
We did finish.
Look at that nice golden brown color on the gorgonzola crust.
And this is the color that we were looking for. And
beautiful.
This is a larger portion. This is a 16-ounce portion
is what we serve
on the menu.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But certainly for a family or a party, we could slice it and serve it over rabe.
Gotta love that.
Nice
I'm all good with it.
All right, this is a recipe you want, or even more information on Providence Restaurant Weeks. For both of those, you can head on over to roadshow.com.